Hot. This is Eric J coming at you with street news. No, we ain't professional, and neither is 26-year-old Drayvon Perkins, who have confessed to raping his 3-year-old female relative. So look, according to the reports, Drayvon was arrested Tuesday after the girl's mother noticed discharge in her diaper and took her to the hospital for an observation. A doctor later confirmed she had been infected with 2 sexually transmitted diseases, chlamydia and gonorrhea. Drayvon previously had been diagnosed with chlamydia and gonorrhea, so a police investigation was launched. So they brought Drayvon in for a little sit down, and he admitted while he was high doing drugs, he forced the young relative into sex acts. He said he assaulted the young girl at his apartment while her mother was at work. Listen, we all gotta work, but we can't just be leaving our children alone with anybody while we go to work. And I don't want to assume that this mother knew that he was a rapist prior to her leaving her child alone with him. I also don't want to assume that she knew that he was going to be doing drugs while he was babysitting her 3-year-old child. But let's talk statistics right quick. 93% of all children know the person that's sexually assaulting them. Only 7% of people who assault children are strangers. 59% of them are acquaintances. You know, the boyfriend that's always saying, "That ain't my child, I ain't they daddy, but you so happy to have a man in your life, you could care less if he like your children or not, as long as you happy." 34% of family members. Listen, I'ma say this here, then I'ma let y'all go. Some of us grew up in dysfunctional households. Mom on drugs, daddy on drugs, and even with all that negativity happening around you, you still turned out to be great. But understand, that's not normal. That's not the way that it's supposed to be. You wasn't supposed to experience that. And when you normalize bad behavior, you put children in a place to where they can't distinguish what between what's right and what's wrong. You should want the best for your children. The life that you couldn't have, you should want to give that life to your children. And look, it's okay to treat your children better than you was treated when you was coming up.